So today I'm going to show you how to upload a reel or short video to your Facebook account. So there are two different types of Facebook account. There is the personal stroke creator account and there is your business account. I'm going to show you how to put a reel up or a short video to both of them. So I already have my video recorded on my phone, and it is a 1 minute 20 second video. So all you have to do is you need to go into your Facebook account. So the first one I'm going to show you how to do is to upload it to your Facebook profile stroke creator professional account. So the best way to find out and make sure that you're on the right account is to go to the profile picture at the bottom right hand corner, and you'll see that it has your name. And when you click it, it's usually going to be a picture of you, and then it's got a background picture, maybe your family or something that you do, or the landscape or something like that. Then, in order to upload a short video to this account, all you need to do is scroll down, and where it says your posts, you get an option for reel or live. If you click the reel option, it's going to give you some choices. So you can see at the top, you've got camera, music, template, your content, and saved. Or you can just go straight into the camera roll area here and click the video you want. Now, sometimes it might say you have limited access to your camera roll, just give it access to it. So then what we do is we choose the video in question. So I'm going to click this one. It's actually 1 minute 30 seconds. And you can see that it's automatically shown up on the screen in the right proportion because this has been recorded in a vertical video format. You can see at the bottom that it says edit or switch to post. We don't want to put it to a post, we want it to be a reel, but I want to show you how to edit. So just click the edit option, and you can see that you have quite a lot of different things that you can do. At the bottom, you can add more media, so whether that's a picture or more videos, you can go ahead and do that. You can replace what's already there, you can increase the speed, you can crop it, and that says new, so you can actually crop it a little bit, maybe the top, the bottom, change the rotation, etc. etc. You can also mirror, so you can flip it around. So maybe if you've got a video that has a bit of writing on and the recording has got the writing the wrong way around, you can just flip it around so that people can see it the right way around. And you can split it. So when you split it basically means you click on it, move it along, and you click split, and it will cut that slice. Then maybe you can add something in between that. If you do something you don't want, you've got this little go back button. So click that, and it will take that last action away. Okay, now if you want to add audio, you just click the audio button. And you can add any of the music, and you can add any of the music that you want. Once you're happy with the music, just click on the music and it will put that in for you. If you want to take the music out again, just go back button and it will remove it for you. Now, if you want to add text or maybe a title to your video, you can click add text and you can add some text. So maybe I might just do here, I might put air fryer. And then you can see at the bottom, you've got colors if you want different colors. You've also got this option to put a background or an outline or a color background. You can change it around depending on what you want. Also, when you click the writing, you can see that there are different ways of having the title come up or the writing as well. If you want to make it bigger, just use that toggle and it will come up and down. And also, once you go back into the editing, you can actually make it so that you can time the title. So I'm going to bring it right back to the beginning, so that it only shows up a little bit at the beginning, like so. And if I pull it back, I've got it there. I'm going to lift it up a little bit. You can just do that by wiggling your finger up and down. You can make it a little bit bigger like that as well. Then once you're happy, click done. Now you can do this option to reduce the noise. So that's like if there's any outside noise. You can also add text, effects, and stickers from the front end as well. And then what you can do then is you click next, and it will take that thumbnail where you click next. You can see that it says edit. So then you can choose where you want your thumbnail to show up. So I want mine at the beginning where it said that air fryer option. So you can choose where you want the thumbnail to be if you want it in a particular position of your video. Click save. And then your video is ready to go up. So all you need to do then is put your description in. So I've already prepared my description. And then come back and paste it into the area. You can, of course, write it in as you want as well. One thing to say about Facebook Reels is that there is no return option on the keyboard. So when you write a sentence, you can see on the keypad at the bottom that there's no option to press return. So you can't make a new line. So it is all going to be sort of scrambled together. And then all you have to do is click done, and you can see that you can add your location, you can tag and collaborate with other people, you can share it onto Instagram if you want. I'm actually going to turn that off for the time being, just for this one. So I'm going to click off, and you get the option to turn off for all reels or turn off for this reel only. I'm going to just do this reel only because I've already shared it onto my Instagram account. Once you've done that, close it down. Then all you need to do then is either schedule it to go out later, so you can publish it now or schedule for later. If you schedule for later, just click it, choose the date and the time, and click save. I'm going to go for now. So all I do is I just click share now, and it's going to share that to my personal Facebook account, which is at the moment what's known as a creator stroke professional account. So wait for that to go up. Okay, so that's gone up onto my account. So all you have to do then is just refresh your page. And as you can see, there is the reel. So if I click on it, you can see that the reel has gone up into my Facebook account. And you can see that you can like it, leave a comment, share it, or actually even send it to WhatsApp. So how do you upload a short video or reel to your Facebook business page? Well, it's a similar situation, except all you do is you come to the bottom right-hand corner, and where it's got your name, you can see that there is like a little drop down. If you click that, you can then choose the page that you want to act as. So I'm going to go into my business page. And it's pretty much the same situation, except at the moment I have this option to create a story or create a reel. If I go to my page itself, again, scroll down and you get the option to create a reel. So click on the reel, the same type of editor at the top, choose a video. So this time I'm going to go for more business one. Again, click the edit button. Same situation again, you've got your ad, replace, speed, crop, mirror, and split. Once you're happy with everything, just click the done button, click the next button. Again, add your description in, add your topics, share to group, share to your story, add to playlist if you wish. And then if you want to, you can schedule. So again, it's exactly the same way in your Facebook business page as it is in your profile. The only difference is that this is going to go onto your page and not your profile. So I'm just going to grab the description to show you. Pop the description into the area. Again, you don't have that return option, like I said before. And then just go ahead and share now. And it's going to share that reel or short video to your Facebook business page. So pretty much the same as your profile or creator page, exactly the same editing suite as before. So I hope you found that video useful. Don't forget that if you have any questions about uploading short vertical video to Facebook, drop them in the comments below this video. Don't forget to give me the thumbs up and smash that subscribe button, and do share this video with anyone else that you think might find it useful. My name's Anita Wong. I help you to use video strategically across social media to raise visibility for your business. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.